We have a lot of chatter in Europe and, of course, the Middle East and India are talking about this. Hashtags like Gaza under attack, free Palestine, and Israeli terrorism are all trending worldwide with tens of millions of tweets each. The hashtags, along with videos like this, are going viral. This shows the aftermath of an Israeli missile in Gaza that killed a woman and her family. The woman was out shopping in her car for fish to have as breakfast for the first day of Eid. Well, political cartoons and graphics are also being used to share Palestinian stories. The caption to this one reads, "This is not religious, this is humanitarian." Online, people all over the world are urging others to share their own social media accounts to speak out and share hashtags, like this woman who has more than a million followers.
Now, you don't need to be Arab, you don't need to be Muslim, you don't even need to be Palestinian to stand up for injustice in Palestine. This is not political, this is not religious, and this is not anti-Semitic. This is humanitarian, and this is about standing up for the oppressed. Now, the problem is there are many Palestinians dying, and there's no media coverage to help. If you would like to help, I advise you to use your platform and to use your voice to let the world know what's happening in Palestine.
Well, the way the media is covering this story is also being criticized online. Here, American writer Sean King edited a New York Times article and headline, and this one is being shared online, too. It's from Reuters. Political researcher Asal Rad said, "Dear journalists, we can't keep doing this for you." She said, "Stop reducing decades of brutality to just calling it clashes." She went on in a tweet to say that it's so important for people with a platform to spread the message. Oppressor and oppressed, she says, are not two equal sides.